Students, hope you are well and working hard to achieve your goals. So as we had started our chapter 11, Social Responsibility of Business and Business Ethics. So as in the yesterday, we had discussed responsibility of business towards different interest groups and responsibility of business towards the protection of environment. So today we will discuss the last topic of this chapter, that are business ethics, its meaning, elements, concept and importance or significance. After that we had discussed the social values and business ethics. So in these topics today we will discuss, first of all, there are some key terms. After that we will discuss the examples of companies that follow the business ethics in India. Then we will discuss the case study of Satyam Computer Services Limited. After that we will start our topic, that is business ethics, its meaning, ethical principles, elements and importance or significance. After that we will discuss the social values and business ethics, case study of Tata Groups that follow the business ethics in their business, and some examples of bad ethics. So first of all we will discuss our key terms. So first one is business ethics. So as simply we can say that it is a combination of two words, business plus ethics. So simply we can say that the business is an occupation or trade and purchase and sale of products or services to make a profit. For example, like farming business, or Reliance Industries is the business of Amban. So these are the examples that we are denoted in the business. Next is ethics. So ethics means moral principles or code of conduct that govern a person's behavior or conduct of an activity. So simply we can say that business ethics or ethics defines what is right and what is wrong. It refers to the set of moral values or standards which govern or guide the activities of a businessman. So now there are some examples of companies that follow the business ethics in India. So in today, or we can say that the two Indian companies have named in the list of world's ethical companies by American think tank Ethisphere Institute, that are Tata Steel and Wipro. So these are the two companies that follow the business ethics in India. So now we will discuss the case study of Satyam Computer Services Limited. So Satyam Computer Services Limited, a Hyderabad based company, was promoted by B. Ramalinga Raju in 1987. It provides software solution services in many areas throughout the year or throughout the world. It grew at a very fast pace over the period of time and became the fourth largest IT company of India. So the company won many awards in recognition of its outstanding work, like top best managed companies in India, recognition of commitment, TDWD best practices award. So all these awards suggest that the company was maintaining a very high ethical standards in its working. So this is the former chairman and managing director, that is B. Ramalinga Raju. So similarly, its former chairman and managing director, that is Ramalinga Raju, achieved many awards for his outstanding achievements, such as DataQuest Man of the Year, Earnest and Young Entrepreneur Award, Gold Peacock Award. All these awards convey adoption of ethical practices by the Raju. However, internally, things were quite unethical. So, Raju confessed unethical practices on January 7, 2009. He confessed that the company's balance sheet of September 30, 2008 contained inflated figures of cash and bank balance as well as profit. Accrued interest was not existent. Then, inflated amounts of debtors in the books of accounts. Understated liabilities in the books of accounts. So, he further stated that what started as a marginal gap between the actual operating profit and the one related or reflected in the books of accounts grew over the years. It has attained unmanageable proportions as the size of the company grew significantly. As the promoters held a small percentage of equity, the concern was that poor performance would result in a takeover, thereby exposing the gap. So, after this confession, there were many actions from the government agencies are taken, like police took Raju in custody and filed cases against him, like under various sections of Indian Penal Code, Company Law Board dissolved the Board of Directors. Some other government agencies instituted inquiries of various types and so on. As a result, Industries Circle criticized by the Raju section. Then, share price of the company was dissolved, or we can say that reduced. Then, employees leaving the company as they were not supposed to work in that company. So, subsequently, Satyam Computer was taken over by Mahindra and Mahindra Group. So, we can say that what a pitiable or pitiable situation it was for a Satyam Computer, which was once considered as an excellent company. So, now we will discuss the meaning of business ethics, that why it is necessary for business to follow the business ethics in their business activities. So, ethics is a branch of social science. It deals with moral principles and social values. It helps us to classify what is good and what is bad. It tells us to do the good things and avoid doing bad things. So, business ethics, simply we can say that a code of conduct for business. Ethics means character, guiding beliefs, standards or ideals that prevail in a group, community or people. For example, business ethics like not to adopt dishonest means to earn profit, not to cause harm to others to earn profits, to sell genuine goods, to sell goods at reasonable prices, to pay taxes honestly. So, business ethics, if we are performing a business behavior and follow the ethics in the business, we are ethical and provides a social welfare in the economy. And if we are not following the business ethics, that is neglect of a social welfare. Now we will discuss the ethical principles of business. So, the important ethical principles that a business should follow. First one is, do not deceive or cheat customers by selling substandard or defective products. Then, do not destroy or distort competition. Do not tarnish the image of competitors by unfair practices. Then, do not resort to hoarding, black marketing or profiteering. Pay taxes and discharge other obligations promptly. Refrain from secret kickbacks or payoffs to customers, suppliers, administrators, politicians. Ensure sincerity and accuracy in advertising, labeling, and packaging. Then, ensure payment of fair wages to and fair treatment of employees in an organization. After that, make accurate business records available to an authorized person. So these are some ethical principles that the business should follow in the business activities. Next one is elements of a business ethics. So business ethics is an umbrella term which covers all business practices which are desirable from the point of view of the society. Business ethics emphasize making a business honest, just, and responsible citizen. Ethics aims perfection in the conduct of life. It guides the lawmakers to have perfect rules for all human behavior. The concept of equity is implied in ethics. It aims at fair and just treatment to all. Business ethics creates self-maintained discipline on the part of the businessman. Next, we will discuss the importance or significance of business ethics. So first one is that business is a part of a society. For example, like in Amritsar, Metro, Easy Day, Vishal Megamart, Walmart. These are the examples, or we can say that the businesses that work within a society. Social values must become the guiding principles for doing a business. Then, second point is when business fails to behave in or to behave in accordance with the society's expectations, then it may lose its image and its very right to exist. For example, Satyam Computers. They lose their image when they show wrong accounts to the general public. Third one is a businessman is expected to serve as a trustee of various groups. Various groups includes like workers, customers, suppliers. These are the part of the business, so they have to work as a trustee to these various stakeholders. Next one is, as such, it must obey the social norms and expectations. For example, Tata Groups. They provide fair wages to employees, good quality products to customers, and at a reasonable prices. So, they obey the social norms and expectations of the customers. Next one is, various laws reflect the ethics of the society. Various acts like Consumer Protection Act, Workmen Compensation Act, Environmental Protection Act, etc. So if a trade is not ethical, it will certainly attract the intervention of the law. So we have to follow these acts or laws that are provided by the government. Next one is, consumers are no longer at the mercy of the business firms. For example, a person doesn't or does not like Flipkart app because of poor quality, then he can go for Amazon, Myntra for shopping purpose. In this way, if the business does not follow the ethics, then it loses its place in the market. They have formed various business organizations to maintain the discipline in business. So to avoid confrontation with the customers, it is advisable for the business to follow the ethical practices. Now we will discuss the next topic, that is social values and business ethics. So in this, first question arises that whether the profit maximization is the only objective of business. So the answer is no, as business ethics do not permit to adopt dishonest means. A businessman should not cheat his customers. ही मस्ट डिस्क्लोज ऑल द फैक्ट्स टू द गवर्नमेंट. सो सोशल वैल्यूज रेफर्स टू द बेसिस ऑन विच मेंबर्स ऑफ अ सोसाइटी जज ईच अदर्स कंडक्ट और बिहेवियर. सो सोशल वैल्यूज इन रिलेशन टू द बिजनेस एक्टिविटीज आर दैट ही हैज टू फाइंड वट आर द फीचर्स ऑफ अ गुड बिजनेस, देन वट ऑब्जेक्टिव्स आर नेसेसरी फॉर परस्यूइंग बिजनेस, हाउ मस्ट अ बिजनेस मैन कंडक्ट हिज बिहेवियर इन द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ द सोसाइटी. सो मॉरल प्रिंसिपल्स लाइक कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट और बिहेवियर ऑफ पीपल इन सोसाइटी मे बी कॉल्ड अ सोशल एथिक्स. दीज मॉरल प्रिंसिपल्स मस्ट गवर्न बिजनेस एक्टिविटीज इन रिलेशन टू सोसाइटी. सो इन द लॉन्ग रन द सक्सेस ऑफ द बिजनेस डिपेंड्स ऑन द फेयर एंड ऑनेस्ट डीलिंग्स विद द पब्लिक एंड अडॉप्टिंग प्रैक्टिसेस विच आर बेनिफिशियल टू सोसाइटी. So now we will discuss the case study related to the Tata company. So as Tata, we never compromised on ethics. So Tata companies has major objective to fulfill the business ethics in their business activities. So Tata business ethics principles are, first one is national interest, then financial reporting and records that they prepare and maintain its accounts fairly and accurately. Then competition. So fully support to the development and operation of competitive open markets. Then they provide the equal opportunities to employees and employers in the business and provide jobs who are qualified to that job. Next, it includes gifts and donations. So its employees shall neither receive nor offer or make directly or indirectly any illegal payments, remuneration, gifts, donations related to the business activities. Next one is government agencies. So a Tata company and its employees shall not, unless mandated under applicable laws, offer or give any company funds or property as donation to any government agency or its representative. Next one is political non-alignment. So its principle is be committed to and support the constitution and governance system of the country in which it operates. So now there are some examples of bad ethics. So the examples are like McDonald's, that they do not provide or they are not fulfilling the business ethics in the business, and they sold unhealthy food, exploiting the workers and children, tortured animals and destroyed the Amazon rainforest. So these are the examples of bad ethics that they follow in their business activities. Next one is Walmart. So their unethical business practices are like provide or child labor violations, use of illegal workers, labor union opposition and gender orientation. So these are the examples of bad ethics that is followed in the business activities or by the various businesses. So now, as Mahatma Gandhi says that you must not lose faith in humanity. Humanity is an ocean. If a few drops of the ocean are dirty, the ocean does not become dirty. So this is all about today's topic related to the business ethics. So now you have to write your question answers. So your first question is, define business ethics and explain its significance. After that, you have to write your second question, that is, explain the elements of business ethics. So go through the various YouTube links so that you can get the more knowledge related to the topic, that is business ethics, and write the answer of these questions.